Hello. At this time, we'll talk about the web development. For example, let's see how to create a custom photo album. We begin with making a web page mockup, just a picture. Then we slice the document to pieces. Let it be the album title, the main photo, four previews of the neighboring photos, and the text links. Then we assign hyperlinks to all the navigation slices. Lastly, we save the document as HTML file and images. The result looks approximately like this. So far, I've saved just two pages. The page 3 isn't ready yet. Let's create it right now. The graphic mockup is already here. Now I have to slice it. To begin with, I mark up the page with the guides. Thus, I've defined the title area. Next, let's proceed to the navigation bar. Done. Now I open the scripts catalog, go to Slices category, and run Slices from Guides script. To make things clearer, I show the slice numbers and hide the guides. At this point, the picture is sliced into 32 pieces. Let's try a different approach. I activate the rectangular marquee tool and define the next page hotspot. Then I open the scripts dialog and run slice from selection script. Done. To create another slice of the same size, I drag the selection onto the previous link and then make a slice from the selection. To slice the main photo, I hold down Ctrl key, click the layer thumbnail, and create another slice. Then I Ctrl click the preview one and make a slice from the selection. Now the preview 2, preview 3, and preview 4. And what about modifying the created slices? For instance, if I need to resize this one. With the rectangular marquee, I select an internal portion of the slice. The important thing is the selection corners shouldn't touch the slice boundaries. I open the scripts dialog and run Select Marked Slices script. The slice is selected. I return to the scripts catalog, open the slice options, increase the slice width, and shift it to the left. Okay. Now, I want to align these two slices to each other. I mark the slice 57 with the rectangular marquee. Open the scripts dialog, hold down Shift key, and run Select Marked Slices script. Now that both slices are selected, I run Align Slices script and choose an alignment option. Done. To select several adjacent slices, I mark them like this and run the selecting script. Actually, I don't need these user slices, so I open the Scripts dialog and delete the selected slices. By the way, the selecting script isn't always needed. I mark a slice range with a rectangular marquee, and then run Delete Selected Slices script. I mark some unnecessary slices, delete them, and so on. To join these two slices together, I select them like this and use Combine Slices command. Okay, the slicing is complete. Let's see how to create hyperlinks. I select the preview of the photo number 1, open the Slice Options dialog, and enter the link to the page 1 of the album. Then I select the Preview 2. Open the Slice Options and enter the address of the page 2. I select the Preview 4 and link it to the page 4. I select the Previous button and connect it to the page 2. The next link has to lead to the page 4. Now I mark the Home button and connect it to the index page. And so on. Okay, all is done. It's time to save the created web page. I open the Scripts dialog and run Export Slices script. Now I can preview the page in the real web browser. Well, everything looks as expected. The links seem to work. However, the total size is way too large because all the slices are saved to PNG format. Let's return to PSE and optimize the page. I click on the main photo slice, choose JPEG format, adjust the quality, then I click the Preview 1, hold down Shift key, and add the other previews to the selection. I choose the JPEG format and adjust the quality for the selected slices. Then I select the title slice, hold down Shift key, and select all the text slices. I select GIF format and set the number of colors. Now I select any auto slice with the gray badge. choose GIF format, and define the settings. Notice that all the other auto slices update by themselves. Let's preview the result in the browser. I think the page size is quite reasonable and the image quality is sufficient. So I return to Save for Web Dialog, click Save, and choose the destination folder. Ready. At last, I find the saved page 3 and test its hyperlinks. Finished.